Hello students, I Krunal Jogi welcomes you on behalf of Radhika School Trimba on the live session on real numbers. So in class 9 we already studied a little bit portion about real numbers. So first we will quickly recap that. So as we all know ki real numbers are classified into rational number and irrational number. But rational numbers are further classified into fraction and integers. But integers are again classified into negative numbers and whole number, and whole number is also further classified into zero and natural number. Okay students, so in class 10 we will study this two topic, Euclid's division lemma and the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Okay students, so now let we study Euclid's division lemma. So for Euclid's division lemma we will assume two integers a and b, but positive integers. So let a and b are positive integers, so there is one unique identity, a is equals to bq plus r, where 0 is less than equals to r less than b. It satisfied each and every time. Okay students, so student, as we studied earlier ki 455 is greater than 42, so we will try to solve the examples. Find the HCF of 455 and 42 with the help of Euclid's division lemma. So what I will do, I will write 455 on left hand side. So this is our A, correct students? Then we are having B as 42, correct? So what I have to do, I have to find some value of R here and some value of Q here to get 455. So 455 into 10, 42 into 10 is 420, and then if we subtract 420 for 455, then it is 35. Correct students, so this is our R, this is our B, and this is our Q. So in next step, what we have to do, we have to take 42 as our A and 35 as our B. So we are writing down A on left hand side, so I am writing down 42 here, then equals to sign, then I have to write down B, so our value of B is 35, so I am writing down 35 here. So again I want A is equals to BQ plus R, so again I have to find out Q and R, so I will multiply with 1. So 35 times 1 is 35, if we subtract 42 then it is 7. So this is our value R. So in next step our value of A will be 35, so I am writing down 35 on left hand side, that is equals to our value of B is 7, so I am writing down 7 here. So if we multiply 5 with 7, then it comes 35, so 7 multiplied by 5 is 35 plus 0, we are adding 0. So students, if we are getting 0, if we are adding 0, then this will be the HCF of our number 45 and 42. So how we will write HCF of 455 and 42, that is equals to 7. Correct students? Okay student, so now we will look in these examples. Use Euclid's division lemma to show that square of any positive integer is either of the form 3m or 3m plus 1 for any integer. So we have to remember, we want square of any positive integer. So what we will do, again same thing, we will let a be any integer. And now what will be the value of our b? So value of our b is now 3, because we want to represent the square of any positive integer in form of 3m or 3m plus 1. So let a be an integer and b equals to 3. So the general form of Euclid's division lemma is a is equals to bq plus r, where r lies between 0 and b. Now we will substitute just the value of b in this equation. So after substituting the value, a equals to 3q plus r, where r lies between 0 less than r less than, so 0 less than r less than 3. So the possible values of r is 0, 1 and 2. So I will write down possible values of r: 0, 1 and 2. Now what we have to do? We have to look here. We want square of positive integer. So first of all, we will substitute the values of r in this equation. So that's why it's a is equals to 3q plus 0. And also students, we want square of any positive number, so we have to apply square here. So 3q whole bracket square or 3q plus 1 whole bracket square or 3q plus 2 whole bracket square. Therefore a equals to, now 3q plus 0 is 3q only, so 3 and 3q whole bracket square is 9q square. Correct students? Now 3q plus 1 whole bracket square. So all we know that a plus b whole bracket square is a square plus 2ab plus b square. So we have to use that formula. So here our a is 3q and our b is 1. So a square means 3q square. So 3q square is 9q square plus 2ab. So 2 into 3q into 1, that is 6q. Plus b square, so our b is 1, that's why it's 1 square. 1 square is 1. Or again we have to use a plus b whole bracket square formula. Now our a is 3q but our b is 2, so 3q whole bracket square is 9q square plus 2 into 3q into 2, so that's why it's 12q plus 2 square is 4. So now a equals to, now what we have to do, we have to look in which form we have to represent. We want to represent in 3m or 3m plus 1. So I will take out 3 common from 9q square, so I am writing down 3, and the remaining one is 3q square, so I will write down 3q square in bracket. Or so from this two terms I will take out 3 common, so I am writing down 3 common, and the left is 3q square plus 2q, so I will write down that in bracket plus 1 as it is. Now in this, what I will do, I will split this 4 as 3 plus 1. So I am writing down this 4 as 3 plus 1. So from these 3 terms, I can take out 3 common. So 3 in the bracket, 3q square plus 4q plus 1 plus 1. So this one comes from here. So now what we will do, we will assume some another integers. So I will assume this as k1, this as k2, and this as k3. So 3k1 or 3k2 plus 1 or 3k3 plus 1, where k1, k2 and k3 are integers. So look at this. This all three are in the form of 3m or 3m plus 1. So yes, we can represent square of any positive integers in the form of 3m or 3m plus 1. Okay students, so now we will see this example. So the statement of this example is, show that every positive even integer is of the form 2q, where q is the integer. Okay, so a equals to 2q plus r, where the value of r lies between 0 and 2. So the possible values of r is 0, 1, and 2. Correct students? So each and every time we have to substitute the value of r in this equation, and we have to check ki whether it is coming in the form of 2q or not. If all the times the value of a comes in the form of 2q, then yes, we can say ki each and every positive even integers are in the form of 2q. Okay, so now I am substituting the value of r. So firstly, I am substituting value of r as 0. So a equals to 2q plus r. So our value of r is 0. So I am writing down 0 here. Then or, now we have to substitute our value of r as 1. So a is equals to 2q plus 1 or our value of r, now we have to substitute the value of r as 2. So our equation will become a equals to 2q plus 2. Correct students? So now after simplifying this equation, a is equals to 2q or a is equals to 2q plus 1 or here we can take out 2 common. So after taking out 2 common in the bracket, we have to write q plus 1. So here q plus 1. So now here it is q, 2 in the bracket q plus 1. So we have to assume one number for that. So I am writing down a is equals to 2q or 2q plus 1 or I am taking q plus 1 as 2k1, where k1 is also positive integer. So students, clearly you are able to see ki value of a comes as 2q or 2q plus 1. So we can say that ki each and every positive even integer can be represented in the form of 2q. Okay students, so now we will study the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. So before studying the fundamental theorem of arithmetic, let me discuss some points. So all of we know ki what are known, which are number are known as prime numbers. So prime numbers are which have factor 1 or a number itself. Means what? Suppose I am taking one number a. So the factors of this number will be either 1 or a number itself. This type of numbers are known as prime numbers. So we will use prime factors in the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Okay students, so now we will study the fundamental theorem of arithmetic with one example. So I am taking one random number 3, 2, 7, 6, and 0. So now we have to apply the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. So first of all, we have to find out the prime factors of 3, 2, 7, 6, 0. Prime factors means the factors of that number is a number itself or 1. So this 3, 2, 7, 6, 0 is divisible by 2. So I am writing down 2 here, and 1, 6, 3, 8, 0, because 2 into 1, 6, 3, 8, 0 is 3, 2, 7, 6, 0. Now see here students, 2 is our prime number, so we don't have to factorize this 2 again, but we can factor out 1, 6, 3, 8, 0. So the factors of 1, 6, 3, 8, 0 is again 2 and 8, 1, 9, 0. So factors of 1, 6, 3, 8, 0 is 2 and 8, 1, 9, 0. 2 is again prime number, but 8, 1, 9, 0 is non-prime. So we have to factor out 8, 1, 9, 0. So 8, 1, 9, 0 is again divisible by 2. So we will write down 2 and 4, 0, 9, 5. So the factors of 8190 is 2 and 4095. Now we have to check if this 4095, we have to find out the factors. So we have to check whether this number is divisible by 3 or not. So for checking, we have to add the digit of 4095. So 4 plus 0 is 4, 4 plus 9 is 13, 13 plus 5 is 18. So yes, 18 is divisible by 3, so this number is divisible by 3. So I am finding out the factors of 4095 as 3 and 1, 3, 6, 5. So the factors of 4095 is 3 and 1365. So 3 is our prime number, but we can find out the factors of 1365. So the factors of 1, again we have to check whether 1365 is divisible by 3 or not. So again we have to add the digits. So 1 plus 3 is 4, 4 plus 6 is 10, and 10 plus 5 is 15. So 15 is divisible by 3. That's why this number is also divisible by 3. 3 and 55. Now what you have to do students, you have to continuously go like this here. But I am writing down here because I doesn't have space. So now again we have to find out the factors of 455. So we have to check whether this number is divisible by 3 or not. So 4 plus 5, 9, 9 plus 5, 14. So this number is not divisible by 3, but this number is divisible by 5. So I will write down 5 and 91. So 91 is also a prime number. So we find out the prime numbers of 3, 2, 7, 6, 0. So we can write down 3, 2, 7, 6, 0 as 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5 into 91. Okay students, these are the factors of 3, 2, 7, 6, 0. So we are having 3 times 2, so we can write down this as 2 to the power 3. We are having 3 twice, so we can write down 3 to the power 2 into 5 to the power 1 into 91 to the power 1. So this is how the fundamental theorem of arithmetic works. In short, generally we have to find out the prime factors of any number. Okay, student. So now we will solve this example with the help of fundamental theorem of arithmetic. So we studied that in fundamental theorem of arithmetic, we are finding out the prime factors. So first of all, our number is 12. So we will find out the prime factors of 12. So I will write down 12 here. So the prime factors of 12 is 2 and 6, but 6 is also again. Okay. So here I am writing down 12, correct? So now we will factor out 12 as 2 and 6, but 6 is again also be factorized 2 and 3. So I am writing down 2 into 2 into 3, correct? So these are the prime factors of 12. Now our second number is 22. So 22. 22 is divisible by 2. So factors of 22 are 2 and 11. Both are prime numbers. So 22 equals to 2 into 11. Now our number 40 is 44. So the 44 is divisible by 2. So 2 into 22. So again 22, already we find out the factors of 22, 2 into 11, so 2 into 2 into 11. So these are the prime factors of 12. So what we have to do, we have to rewrite this factors of 12. It is 2 into 2 into 3, so we can write down this as 2 to the power 2 into 3, correct students? Here we are only having one term of 2 and one term of 12, so we will not do anything. Here also we are having 2 twice, so we can write down this as 2 square into 11. Okay students, now listen carefully. We are finding out the HCF first. So what we have to do, I will write down HCF. HCF of what numbers? 12, 22 and 44. So all of you know that HCF is highest common factor. So we have to look which number is common in 12, 22 and 44. Two is common, so I will write down 2 here. And now power, the smallest power of 2 we will take. So here the power of 2 is 2. Here the power of 2, if there is nothing, then we can write down 1. And here the power of 2 is 2. So the smallest power of 2 is 1. So I will take, write down 1 here. So 2 raised to 1 is 2. So the HCF of 12, 22 and 44 is 2. Now LCM. LCM of 12, 22 and 44, correct students? So for finding out LCM, first we will discuss LCM. So LCM is least common multiple. So what we have to do, we have to write down each and every number, but the number is repeating, then we will not write that number again. So here it is 2 and 3, so I will write down 2 and 3. Now this is having number 2 and 11, but 2 is already written by us, so we have to just write down 11 and 44, 2 and 11. So both the numbers are here, 2 and 11. So LCM is 2 into 3 into 11. Now we have to look for the power. So for finding out LCM, we have to write the maximum power. So maximum power of 2 first. So 2 square, here it is 2 square, here it is 2 raised to 1, and here it is 2 square. So maximum power of 2 is 2. Now we have to check for the 3. So here, if there is nothing, then we can write down 1. So 3 is only one time here, and the power of 3 is 1. So I have to write down 1 here. Now 4-11. 11 also we are having 11 here and here. If there is nothing, then we can write down 1. So the maximum power of 11 is also 1. So 2 square is 4. 3 raised to 1 is 3. And 11 raised to 1 is 11. So 4 into 3, 12. 12 into 11. 132. So the LCM of 12, 22 and 44 is 132. Okay students, now we will study terminating and non-terminating decimal. But before, we will quickly recap about rational number and irrational number. So the rational number can be represented in the form of P upon Q. But what is the condition? Q will not equals to 0. If this condition satisfied, then it is a rational number. And we all know that irrational number cannot be represented in the form of P upon Q. Okay student, so now if we want to check whether the given number has terminating decimal or non-terminating decimal, so for that we will have one concept. So whenever we are having denominator, na, if we are able to represent that denominator in the 2 raised to n or 5 raised to m form, then and then only we can say ki this rational number has terminating decimal. If we are not able to represent the denominator in 2 raised to n or 5 raised to m form, then we are not able to say ki it is a terminating. Rather, it is non-terminating decimal. So we will see one example. Suppose I am having one number 31 upon 64. So this is in the form of P upon Q. I want just denominators. So our denominator is 64. Then what we have to do, students, we have to find out the factors of 64. So 64 is 2 times 32. So 32 is 2 times 16. 16 is 2 times 8. 8 is 2 times 4. 4 is 2 times 2. So, see, factors of 62 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Means I can write down 2 to the power 6. So, see, students, this factors of 64 comes to the power 2 to the power 6. So, yes, this satisfied our this condition. Ki it can be represented in the form of 2 raised to n or 5 raised to n. So, our number 31 upon 64 has terminating decimal. Okay students, so now we will look for the example which has non-terminating decimal. So suppose I am taking number 5 upon, let's say, 30. So this is in the form of P upon Q. So we have to find out factors of 30. So 30 is 2 times 15. So 2 into 15. But factors of 15 are 3 and 5. So 3 into 5. So 30 equals to 2 into 3 into 5. Correct, students? This has both 2 and 5. But see students, here we are having 3. We have any other number except 2 and 3, then it is a non-terminating decimal. So our number 5 upon 30 has non terminating decimal. Okay, students. So students, if you like the online session of real numbers, you can like this video and you can share this video to your colleagues and you can subscribe to Radhika School Rajkot channel.